As I pondered various complex scientific concepts, as one normally does, I had a thought. Could your nervous system really power a light bulb? Well, maybe just a low-voltage one. Here is the basic structure of a multipolar neuron. We have the dendrites, the cell body, which contains all the necessary organelle, like the nucleus, and we have the axon branch. This particular neuron is myelinated, but this is not always the case. Myelin sheaths are simply made of Schwann cells that have been wrapped around the axon. In between the myelin sheaths, we have the ever-important nodes of Ranvier, and at the end of the neuron are the axon terminals. Now let's take a closer look and see what really happens in a node of Ranvier. Taking a closer look at the membrane of a neuron, in this case the exposed portion called the node of Ranvier, we see that of course there is the phospholipid bilayer making up the membrane, which separates the cytoplasm of the neuron pictured on the bottom from the outside of the cell pictured on top, but there are also many, many protein channels and transport proteins. We have the sodium channels, which regulate the flow of sodium into and out of the cell, the sodium ions themselves, the potassium channels, which regulate the flow of potassium, the potassium ions themselves, and the sodium-potassium pump, which need ATP to transport 3 sodiums and 2 potassiums. Okay, now let's add the ions. Generally, potassium ions are more abundant inside the cell and sodium ions are more abundant outside, but overall the inside of the cell at its resting state is negative relative to the outside. This generates a resting potential of about negative 70 millivolts. Now when a neuron is stimulated, which we will go into more detail about later, there is a local depolarization, and when the depolarization crosses the threshold of about negative 55 millivolts, an action potential will be fired and spread along the axon. Now this action potential is facilitated by the opening of these voltage-gated channels. Voltage-gated sodium channels will open and sodium will diffuse into the cell following the concentration gradient. This causes your local depolarization in which your charges change. This causes the voltage-gated potassium channels to open and potassium rushes out of the cell, repolarizing it. And as the action potential continues down the axon, ion pumps will use ATP, or cellular energy, to manually restore the original resting potential. This process will then continue to repeat itself down the axon, thus the electrical message is being transported. Okay, now that we know how a signal moves along a single neuron, let's take a look at what happens once it reaches the end of a neuron, or the axon terminal. Once this message reaches the axon terminals at the end of the neuron, it is converted into a chemical message and transported through a process called neurotransmission. As the action potential reaches the axon terminal, voltage-gated calcium channels open, and positive calcium ions pictured as yellow dots enter the cell. This causes vesicles containing neurotransmitters to fuse with the membrane and release the neurotransmitters into the synaptic cleft. These neurotransmitters bind to ligand-gated ion channels and cause them to open, allowing sodium to enter the cell and potassium to leave, once again depolarizing the region. And if depolarization crosses the threshold, an action potential is generated and the message continues being propagated. And that is how the universe... Wait. Retake. And that is how your neurons... Wait, no, the other picture. No, can you just pull up a picture of a neuron? Thank you. And that is how your neurons transmit signals.